Hello everyone, this video is in continuation to our videos for chapter genetics. We have already discussed the monohybrid cross in the previous video. In this video we will be talking about the dihybrid cross in detail. Fine, so watch the video till the end. I'll in detail explain you ki ye cross kaise banana hai, how do you make it for the paper. It's a sure shot question for your papers, either monohybrid or dihybrid. So hame dono hi crosses acche se karne hai. Please share the channel as much as you can. Help me and you grow our channel. Let's start with the dihybrid cross. Now, as in monohybrid cross, I told you how to identify that it's a monohybrid cross. When you have only one trait or character in the statement. Jaise pichle video mein we just took the character of height. So it's a monohybrid cross. But when we talk about di means two. When there are two traits in a statement, like for example, find F2 generation when a tall plant with green pods is crossed. I'm sorry, यहां पे I'll just write it साथ ही में so that tall plant with green pods is crossed with short plant with yellow pods. So that would be okay. So as I told you, you must go through the table which is given, wherein all the traits are given, dominant recessive is given in your book. Watch it and learn it carefully so that you know ki dominant or recessive kaun sa trait hai. Dominant is always expressed with a capital alphabet, recessive is always expressed with a small alphabet. Fine, so we start the cross now. How do we make it? We follow the same thing, the same as we did earlier. What is he saying? That this is crossed with this. Fine, again the same thing. First F1 generation nikalna hai hamein. We'll do the same again. One each we are going to take. We'll make this checkerboard, but yahan pe difference, what will be the difference? That we are going to take one each, TG, TG, here also, smalls, both, and then we cross them. What do we get? To Mendel's surprise, again, he got all the offsprings as the same. That means, in all the boxes, the combination which he got was this. Ab ye usko dikha. So what did he get? That the plant was tall, all the plants were tall with green pods. Koi bhi variation was not there. There was no variation. Sare ek jaise the. In order to take, or you can say, in order to find out variations, again, he performed the process of crossing. So he crossed the two offsprings which were produced. So he crossed these. This is known as selfing or crossing, as I told you. Now here we have a big table to make. So I'll give you a tip also, a trick to learn these so that you don't forget them in your paper. So how do we do it? I have a line which I ask the children to learn. Sabse pehle to decide which alphabet is going to come first and which is going to second. I'll take it in serial order, T first and G second, after that. So it is capital, small, capital, small. First one alphabet. Bacche kya karte hain? Capital yahan pe G likh denge. No, I've taken T first. So capital, small, then comes the other one. Capital, small, small. Learn this line. Capital, first is capital, small, then capital, small, small. Learn this line, you are done. Yahi wala you will copy here, this side also. Isko aise hi hum yahan pe bhi copy kar lenge and then we will start the cross. It's a tip to learn how to make the combinations or the combinations of the alleles. Now the crossing is simple. This will be crossed with all of them. So what do we get? Now capital T, small t, capital N, small. Now this again will be crossed with all. So capital T, small t, both capitals. Capital तो है ही नहीं यहाँ पे. Small t, capital G's both. Capital T, capital G small. Both small G's, one capital G small. Capital T's, one capital small g. Capital T, G and G. Capital both small. Next is capital smalls. Then capital D small. Capital name. Both small T's and one capital G and one small. Capital T small t, both small G's, and here we have all the smalls. This is what we are going to get when we will cross them. Now the main work starts. Now we have to find out kis box mein kitne kaun se combinations hain. For that, please learn the ratio, that is genotypic ratio. It also has genotypic and phenotypic ratio. Genotypic ratio of a dihybrid cross is very long. Not in your course, you will do it in 12th. Phenotypic ratio we are going to write. So that is 9 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1. 9 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1. So now we'll find out. First of all, 9. Wo wale jinne T is capital and G, both are capitals. This where T is capital but the G's are small. This where the T is small but G is capital. Yes. And the last one wherein both are small. So we are going to find out kitne boxes mein kaun se combinations present hai. Let's just start. First of all, capital G and small. So we'll mark them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 9 combinations are the one jahan pe the plants are tall with green pods. Ab jo count kar liye, we will not count them again. We will take the other ones. So jahan pe capital T hume dekhna hai, G hume dekhna hi nahi hai. So we'll start with capital T's. Only capital T. 1, 2, and 3. So three boxes where only capital T is present. That means the plant is tall, but the pods are yellow. Next, we have to see only capital G. We don't have to see the other allele. So this is 1, 2, and 3. So 3 are the ones where the plant is short but the pods are green, and we are only left with one here, that is a recessive trait where it is short with yellow pods. So this is how you calculate ki ye ratio jo hamara phenotypic ratio aaya, how does it come. So when you write this, your answer is complete. Very easy to find out. Just you need to remember this. Agar ye theek hai and you know this ratio, your answer will never be wrong. Fine? When you write this, copy this here, cross them off, aur phir uske baad jab aapko ratio pata hai, to you need to know pehle mein both capitals will be found, then one capital, agle mein dusra wala capital, agle mein both small. So when you will find it out, you will get this result. So this is how we make a dihybrid cross to get full marks. So dihybrid cross explains law of independent assortment. How is it so? As you see that there are two alleles present. One is for tallness, that is, or you can, I'll write it like this. One is for height and other is for color of pods. In dono ka ek dusre pe koi influence nahi hai. That means they are present together, but they are independent of each other's expression. आपस में इनका कोई लिंक नहीं है. कोई ये नहीं है कि पॉड अगर ग्रीन है तो इट इज अफेक्टिंग द हाइट, और द हाइट इज टॉल और शॉर्ट इट इज अफेक्टिंग. नो. सो दे आर इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ ईच अदर्स एक्सप्रेशन, विच इज लॉ ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट असॉर्टमेंट. सो दिस वॉज एक्सप्लेन्ड बाय मेंडल बाय गिविंग दिस डेरिवेशन. In our next video, we'll take up the new chapter, that is absorption by roots. So keep watching, liking, sharing, subscribing. Thank you.